for a spot in the semifinals, and winning this game earns you an additional $75,000. And suddenly, it's easy for us to make those decisions, but when you're those players sitting up there and you're thinking about the money, and you're thinking about, you know, the implications of being in the semifinals, that becomes a much more difficult decision. So a lot of times I tell fans, you kind of have to temper those thoughts a little bit, because as much as we would love to see that crazy thing come out right now, it might be the perfect time to do it, you still have to remember there's so much on the line. And to make a sacrifice that big, even though, say for example, WE is up a game, that's still a lot of risk to put out there, a lot of risk.
I like to see that it's kind of like that almost across all the esports then, that they do, when the things are on the line, they do seem to default back to what's most comfortable for them.
Yeah. I mean, on the flip side, Jack, we have seen some crazy stuff result from these exact types of situations. So I would never count anything out, but at the same token, I'm probably guessing that there's a 99% chance we're going to see completely standard out of both of these guys and nothing like that's going to really blow our minds. And if it does, great. Then we're in for a treat.
Well, speaking of mind-blowing, ladies and gentlemen, the picks and bans have started at last. Finally, we are going to get into the game. And, well, immediately bans coming out. DJ Wheat, thank you very much for joining us on some intense filler.
Thanks for having me, guys. Glad the game's about to get started.
Let the game begin. So, immediately, Jat, the picks and bans have begun, and they are here on your screen. Anivia, Alistar, and Aurelia. No shock there. Same bans as before. Twisted Fate, Orianna, and Blitzcrank banned out this time. Was first pick for Team WE.
There's the main adaptation that was made here. The Shen ban was there in the previous matchup. They've switched it up, and now, actually, a lot of differences coming out. That Blitzcrank was first picked by WE. CLGU had the Ezreal, so this is really going to be a completely unique game.
Absolutely unique. So Ezreal, again, continuing that 100%, picked and banned throughout. Skarner could be the jungler. Sona has been locked in. Sona, 100% record so far. Definitely a pick I feel COG could do well with.
And that's just the standard play here by COG EU. They do know that Sona is somewhat of a generic support, good in almost every scenario. And the main thing that stops Sona, actually, is Blitzcrank, which they've banned out.
Which they've banned out indeed. What will Team WE pick? They've got 40 seconds. Of course, they had a 10-minute break. After we knew it was going to restart, Team WE requested a 10-minute break. They wanted to discuss the strategy, which is fine. You know, they were the ones that chose, yeah, okay, we can reset things, but we want time to talk about it. Looking like they're going to have to react to the Skarner pick with a Maokai. Interesting that Maokai was available, but Snoopy chose to go for Skarner to begin with. Skarner's been very strong in this tournament so far.
And here we could maybe see a Nocturne. We really have to make sure WE doesn't get too upset about this change, because even though COGU was coming back in that last game before we had the disconnect, before we had the problems, they were winning. And if you get that in your mind, you can't have it as a negative thing, which it most likely is. You have to realize, hey, we were winning, let's just go do it again, instead of saying, man, we were winning, we should have already moved on. You've got to get that out of your mind.
And we're seeing the four-man dive comp here from Team WE. The Shen ultimate down the bottom, Nocturne from downtown, sliding straight in there, which is quite relevant since we are in LA downtown. I'm not just pulling that one out for good, but COG, they're going to have seen that. They know what's coming now. They're going to know what to expect in that bottom lane. They know they've got a Sona. They need to react to it. Oh, wow. I don't think I've ever seen Wicked playing Jace, you know, in that top lane, but Jace has been very strong in this tournament.
He did play one game of Jace against Azubu Frost in that best of five they had, but it wasn't the best performance. He's generally struggled with skill shot heavy champions, and that Acceleration Gate Shock Blast combo is very skill shot intensive. And CLGU has seen a type of team comp like this where they have four or five men able to appear in the bottom lane. That was against Moscow 5 at ECC Poland, and they actually got obliterated by it. They locked in the Nocturne Shen very early, so CLGU has had plenty of time to counteract that with their picks and bans. Whether or not they pull that off, they really have to, because this is a dangerous composition for them to handle.
So final pick being selected, Froggen. What AP mid will it be? Will it be Karthus again? Will he go for something different? Went for Cassiopeia in the last match, which obviously got restarted. If you have just joined us, ladies and gentlemen, there was a small internet issue around about 15 minutes into the game. It does happen at these live events. And the fact that we are using 5% of the entire North American internet is not much of a surprise. We are draining the electric of the whole world right now, as people all around the world Europeans staying up through the night, Koreans and Chinese just waking up early to try and watch this one. The North Americans basking in the sunshine of Los Angeles, waiting for this final pick to come through. He's leaving it late. It's going to be Karthus.
He had trouble with Karthus against Oriana in the first game, but that is Froggen's comfortable mid, second probably to Anivia. So really, CLG trying to stay comfortable, trying to be good here. This counter pick back and forth, they burn two bans on Messiah. They really respect him as a player, obviously. Will Karthus be able to go up against Vladimir? Vladimir's going to be able to be pretty aggressive against him early. Can't wait for this game to finally get underway.
Yeah, hopefully it will get underway. And ladies and gentlemen, looks like you all are sat back down. As soon as this picks and bans gets to come out, everybody's like, rush back to your seat. So finally, things are going to get underway. If you want to see Counter Logic Gaming Europe taking this game, taking it to Game 3, it's going to be a hell of a long series if they do. Give them a cheer.
If you want to see World Elite come back from that disconnect, I suppose, and get the second game moving on to the semifinals, let's hear it for World Elite.
Well,
overpowered by the COG chance.
To see who the favorite is here, they want a Game 3. Ladies and gentlemen, what a fantastic crowd you've been. Thank you very much for the patience. Thank you very much at home for the patience of having to sit through that one. We know it's not easy to sit and listen to the three of us for a long period of time. I feel like I was on Live on 3 there for a moment. I got DJ Wheat here. I don't know which one am I. Am I going to be the dollars? Am I Sir Scoots
sure.
right here?
Sure, absolutely.
That makes you you Slasher, unfortunately. Sorry.
Oh. No. Sorry. Slasher's a great guy.
Oh, he's a great guy. He's watching this one as well. I know he is. But we are into the game, ladies and gentlemen. You can see it there on your screen. Let's get things underway. So if you've just joined us, it has been a very long break between. But CLG EU are starting off as the red team. And Team WE, a.k.a. World Elite, we call them WE. That's what we've been requested to call them. They are playing as the blue team. Team WE, of course, 1-0 up as that red side to begin with. And looks like, are we going to see anything crazy coming out? Wicked, of course, on Jace. He's going to be on you, Jat. He's going to be all over you, man, like a rash. He's going to be against Chow Mei in that top lane. So Shen versus Jace is something we saw at the E-Regionals. It did not go very well.
So the Shen is chopping the matchup, and here Wicked's actually running straight into Clear Love, trying to get that push. This is interesting.
He's trying to bait that one. He wanted to go for that aggression. You can see the layways coming down. Clear Love's hit points being taken down. Jace managed to kill him. Messiah going straight in there. The pull trying to slow things down. They pull up towards Snoopy. The taunt comes out. Can Snoopy get away? They got the ignite down on Snoopy, I believe. I think his hit points might drop. He's got the heal going. Krepo's going to get dropped. Wee Zhao picks up first. Froggen's going to get exhausted. They're going to try and turn things around. Wee Zhao's going to be the target. Wee Zhao's on nothing. They flash. They get him. Froggen's got the layways down. Yellow Pete's also taken out very low as well. That's going to be Yellow Pete near drop. Clear Love. Wicked turns around. Wicked goes back in. Chow Mei's got to surely get a taunt across. And it was a 2-1 death-defying exchange for both teams. Everybody going back home. That's the start we wanted.
Wow, and that was the first giant clash we've actually seen pretty much in this tournament. Let's take a gander at what got just eaten up in that fight. I'm lost for words. Lots of flashes. The bottom lane of CLG EU is completely extended. No flash, no exhaust, no cleanses, any of that. Wicked used everything. The only flash remaining on CLG EU is Frong, and he didn't use any summoner spells. Across the board on WE, Chow Mei still has his flash. Messiah still has ignite. So pretty much, there's still a flash on FCZF as well. Even summoner spell usage on both sides. I do have to give the quick advantage there to WE. They got the two kills as well as having more flashes up. So interesting level one, crazy, crazy, crazy engagement. WE really slightly at the start of the game.
Yeah, with that slight lead. But you know, the assists actually spread across pretty evenly. The only person that didn't get anything there was Skarner. So Snoopy struggling out there. So the lane phase is beginning. The jungle invade never happened, which is actually better off for Snoopy to start with because he had so many problems in the first game. His jungle was invaded. He was in all sorts of trouble. So let's take us through this lane phase. Oh, down the bottom, I can see actually a dazzle there on Krepo. Look at how aggressive Wee Zhao immediately goes off the back of that one. Arcane shift into Mystic Shot straight away, ripping the points down of Krepo. Krepo, of course, he's going to be happy to take that. He's the man that's taking the damage. But let's go through the top lane. Jace versus Shen to begin with. We are seeing Snoopy making his way into that top lane. Let's just see, keep with the action a moment, because he looks like he's going to try and hook onto Chow Mei. Of course, no ultimate available. We can definitely get the damage down. Has got exhaust. No, it's in exhaust. Not available because Wicked used it at the very start by the looks of it. So nothing's going to happen as far as I can tell. Snoopy is going to sit around though, so they want to bait Shen closer, but it's surely just going to be a dash away from that one. They are going to go aggression. There's the dash already used them. Are they going to get enough damage? They just want to force Chow Mei back, if anything. Force him to use something. Wicked is going to get knocked back. Use the knockback and just force him back, but he's not going to back off that one.
And he might just try to camp that. We've seen some really legendary camps by some of these junglers just staying in the brush for a really long period of time. That gank a little bit unsuccessful. They did not burn any of Chow Mei's summoner spells. So Wicked trying to get a lot of help up in that lane. His Jace does need to snowball the lane. We've seen the Jace versus Shen matchup. Jace generally very strong early on. And really the one I want to pay a lot of attention to is Messiah against Froggen in here, because the last time his Froggen was slowed down by Messiah's Orianna, what's he going to do against Vladimir? Vladimir's so versatile, sometimes going top or mid. The mid Vladimir much more about aggression, since his pool can take him so close to his tower, he's able to push up and harass without much recourse. Now we see a gank coming up by Clearlove top lane. Will they be able to turn it around on Wicked?
Clearlove going in, he has got double buff available. Wicked on full health though. Full health and full mana. He's actually going to walk straight around into him. Doesn't manage to get through the accelerator gate. Witchgrave, oh, the fear turns him against him. Oh, but the dash, the taunt misses. Wicked might be able to get out of this one. No, the ignite tick should go down. Chow Mei picks it up. That's 3-1 and a successful gank in the top lane.
And that just hurts so bad because his flash was burned at level 1 and it made him not escape. Chow Mei saving it, getting the flash in to create that kill. They knew the summoner spell cooldowns and they took advantage of it before it would be back. When Nocturne gets his first successful gank, that is so dangerous, especially for the bottom lane, because his gank's bottom, once that paranoia darkness comes up, is so, so scary.
So Froggen back in that mid lane against Messiah. And we've seen a Vlad mid last time. He's definitely always going to try and interrupt Froggen. He's not going to let him sit and farm. Is that just Froggen baiting him, though, with the lay waste? I think he may well have been. And Messiah, we saw Vlad mid, and they struggled early on. I'm trying to think who it was against. I'm sure someone with the stats would be able to tell me, but it was definitely a struggle for Vlad mid.
I can't remember.
It must have been against, especially
already
against Karthus.
Is down in minion kills. I think Vladimir should be able to get aggressive on him, however. Especially Messiah, I don't see that being a bad matchup. He can pool under and even dodge the Karthus ultimate in the right situation. I think he can. I should actually know that. I'm sorry, guys. We'll see it the first time it happens. Snoopy trying to clear his jungle up here now.
Well, we said
no disaster for Snoopy early, though, is the great thing. Last game, he was very far behind early on. This game, he is sticking to it, even though he hasn't pulled off a successful gank yet.
Clearlove in the bottom lane, snuck his way into that bottom bushes, waiting to get that gank. We did say, you know, the fact that we knew it was going to be a kill lane. When you pick a Nocturne, you are going to go for kills. So far, Clearlove, it's worked out for him. He's not got his ultimate available just yet. He's some way off. In fact, he's a full level experience off that one. But I don't think Yellow Pete and Crepo are going to be nervous. They're not going to push out for this one. But Wei Zhao, already with the kills early on, 1-0 at the moment, went for the cloth actually early on. So instead chose to go with that. There we go. Clearlove's going to go in, and the Yellow Pete, well aware of that one, just backs out. Very successful in avoiding the damage. 6.5 minutes gone into this game. 3-1 already to Team WE. Snoopy returns to lane, covering off Froggen. Froggen now has hit level 6, so ultimate will be available should they require it. Of course, don't forget the Shen at the top has also just hit level 6, so we could see those crazy four-man dives. Wicked's going to go aggressive on Chow Mei here. He's going to force him back. You know he's going to go back to that tower. Has he got the damage to finish him off, though? Forcing Chow Mei just to back away, but he didn't burn anything. Chow Mei actually doesn't have flash, doesn't have ignite available just yet.
Something Wicked really needs to do in this lane is keep Shen low and keep him harassed. Also stay close to him. If he keeps his E knockback for when Shen tries to ult, he'll prevent him from coming into these fights. So he needs to keep the pressure up. It's difficult when you get first blooded there, but even with that, he's up 9 minions on him, harassing him out of that lane. You can see Chow Mei, very defensive smart build here. Ninja Tabby and a double Doran shield. And here, potentially, we could see something bottom. Snoopy gets caught out with a ward.
That FZZF literally walked into that tri-bush. He face-checked it first. If it had been a split-second difference, he would have gone straight into it with Snoopy and Crepo right there, ready and waiting. Of course, Snoopy is still not to hit 6, has had Nocturne, so neither could have used their ultimate to get in there. As it is, keep my eye. Where is Vlad going? Vlad's just going to ward out that river. So Snoopy, they are three-man stacking on this bottom lane. This is an unusual move from CLG. So Snoopy's hanging around here. Is he waiting to get six and try and draw something out, or is he basically baiting them to maybe make an attack here?
That was a curious choice. I think he was just trying to get to level six as fast as possible. He knew his side of the jungle was already down, so he was just trying to leech as much experience as possible. He needs to be level 6 because clear level is level 6, and the Shen plus Nocturne ultimates can come in at any moment. Snoopy has to be very guarded near lanes, and in order to actually be there to defend his team, he needs that Impale, and he has to get there soon. So much of his farm is deferred to Froggen. Froggen's taking the raids. He'll get this level 6 here. We need to be very careful until Snoopy gets near one of their members.
So clear level picking up the red buff is his own. Oh, Wicked taking very low in that top lane. The Ignite was available for Chao Mei. I feel he could have pushed the pressure there. But now, that means Snoopy is going to pick up the red of his own. Frog comes around, gets that lane tax, does pick up his own race. That's something we saw Messiah was really dealing with in game 1 and 2. Not to confuse things, I guess I could call it 2.1 or something, I'm not too sure.
So Clearlove is actually going to take more farm than other junglers. Nocturne is very much about getting farm. He can't defer nearly as much as something like a Skarner can. This gank is potentially coming in from bottom because they know Snoopy's up top, so they know there cannot be a counter gank. They get any kind of Taric stun, they're going to be going in hard, but he's sitting on a ward, Taric is.
Yeah, that top lane, Shen Jace has returned to lane. This time so well. Wicked choosing an unusual approach there, I think it's safe to say. Berserker Greaves and Vampiric Scepter.
Which is really odd on Jace because Jace's W gives him 3 hits at max attack speed, so generally no one builds attack speed on Jace. He's very much looking for sustained and harass, but honestly, I don't know what he's going to do against Chao Mei's Shen build because that is so solid. With the double Doran shield, all the armor that gives him combined with the Ninja Tabby and being a resourceless champion, I don't think Wicked has the mana to out-harass Chao Mei. I really think Wicked's in a lot of trouble here.
He's just going to try and farm it out, which you would expect is his standard approach. Meanwhile, down that bottom here, the Taric Dazzle going on towards Yellow Pete. Not a great deal doing up from it. Corki, of course, very versatile. Messiah getting caught out by the Wall of Pain there. Froggen going aggressive. Messiah trying to lifesteal his way through it, but the more damage coming out from Froggen had got Snoopy waiting in the wings if he was required. But again, this top lane fight, as you talked about it, Wicked there, just trying an exchange with Chao Mei. Coming out worse off from it by the seams of it. Snoopy now with that Oracle. It's going to clear out, spot that one just above Messiah. Messiah's going to try and put the damage. Nocturne ultimate going on towards Messiah on Snoopy. Snoopy just flashes away. So Splash Burn and the Vlad ultimate was used up there. They really wanted to get that Oracle down.
But keep track here. They did manage to burn his flash, and Snoopy is still very squishy. The Nocturne ultimate will be up before Snoopy's flash. So the next time he tries to clear a ward with an Orphless and the Nocturne ult is up, that Nocturne ult will kill. There's a lot of aggression going now. Bottom actually, get the stun ult.
FZZF is in trouble. They go, not going to have the damage. Snoopy is close. Oh, they got the damage, surely. No, he just popped a heal and said, thank you very much. Chao Mei also ignited down the bottom lane. It's not going to be enough. Wicked, that often happens when Transcends from the Karthus ultimate coming out. Multiple lanes will try different things. They'll try and push their advantage. Snoopy trying to get a peek in there, of course. Nothing coming from it, though. And CLG look like they're going to try and force the Dragon off the back of this one. They know that Team WE have all had to back off.
Good play by CLG EU. Wicked interrupting the Shen ultimate, but the Shen ultimate saving from the damage. This is going to pull them back into it despite the 3-1 disadvantage early. They've farmed in lanes, they've stayed even, and now they're pulling up in the gold. This is CLG EU trying to get back in the game.
CLG EU grinding it back out. They seem to have dealt with those problems very well. In terms of CS, they are up in the top. They are, I'd say, up in the mid, but it's only 3 difference, but they are down again. Wei Zhao really proven to be a problem for Yellow Peak in that bottom lane. 114 CS to 81. Big difference already.
And that's a lot of the Taric being fearful to Krepo's Sona. Sona's very vulnerable if people can get right on top of them, and they've been staying far enough out of harassment range before they want to hard engage, and it's done very well for them to just keep them slightly zoned. Corki's Valkyrie has a very long cooldown, so if he Valks away from one stun, he has to play super passive until his Valk's up again, and I think that's the play pattern they've been creating in the bottom lane to allow Wei Zhao that minion move.
Messiah farming up. Something interesting with the builds. Immediately we've seen a Haunting Guise coming out from Vladimir. This is something we saw in Poland quite a bit.
It's just a stacking Magic Pen build. He's going to be going Sork Shoes, potentially an Abyssal Scepter later, and your damage gets closer and closer to true damage if you can take someone to zero magic resist. You look at Frog, and he's only got 30 MR, so with that Haunting Guise, he's already dealing true damage.
Oh, Yellow Pete, the Ezreal ultimate is not going to catch him, just about flicks past. Thought about going for it. backed away and tried to take it. Morgan picking up the blue buff there, but Yellow Pete already taken low. Is he going to be able to sustain and stay in that lane? He has got Sona, of course, with him. And now Snoopy is just coming up to protect it. Again, I don't think they're going to go for anything here. Snoopy, at the moment, Scarno has not been able to pick anything up, whereas Nocturne also getting involved, has picked up a kill, or an assist, I should say.
And Snoopy has really just been trying to dissuade World Elite from doing anything here, going into the lane and showing yourself. You're not trying to set up a counter gank at that point. You're just trying to make them not want to do anything. It gives up a lot of position, but it goes to what CLG is trying to do right now, which is very clearly stalled. Oh, there's a gank up top.
It's up, and it's going to be Wicked. Wicked surely going to go down from the back of this one. Xiaomei will pick it up. No, clear love stalled it away. The jungler picking up the kill. That's fine. They're going to pass it out. And honestly, that was such a clean executed move that Wicked had no chance.
Didn't even get to burn his flash. He was taunted into the Nocturne Fear, and they actually see Snoopy with that Oracles, but there's no Nocturne ult left, and he's just going to have to concede his jungle here to Nocturne with a two-level advantage.
Two-level advantage, and Clearlove just picks it up, walks away. Snoopy knew that the golem was going to get left, so he goes back in and clears it out. Froggen's going to pick up the race, and oh, he's going to walk straight into Clearlove, actually, but he does manage to put it down. He is on the red buff. Is Snoopy aware of this one? Froggen will have spotted him there. Wall of Pain goes across. Has he got enough to try and take on Clearlove? I think he just wants to force him away, if anything, and make sure and just defend that red buff. He's going to be well aware of it. Of course, Vladimir had gone to pick up the wolves, so he was not in anywhere in the vicinity to try and help out on that one.
And if you really look here, Messiah, keeping up with Froggen and then some, 148 to 147, just doing work on Vladimir. One of the few people who can actually keep up with Froggen's farming ability. Just really trying to counteract CLG's playstyle as much as they can. They did it last game by being almost more passive, more tanky, and beating them at their own game. And even again here, while they do have the early aggression with the Nocturne ganks, at least in mid lane, Messiah not roaming, doing very well to make sure he does not allow Froggen to pull ahead of him.
As it stands, 15 minutes gone. It is 4-1 in terms of kills. No one really getting close to affecting the turrets either. Very much playing into the hands of CLG EU for the long game. And honestly, I feel that Team WE, with this four-man dive strat they've got, they need to try and make it count as much and hard as they can in the lane phase.
So now that Nocturne ult is close to cooldown, the Shen ult is back, that four-man dive becomes again available. And there's a four-man dive for CLG. You might happen right here.
Yeah, they're going to go in towards Messiah. They do hook him up before he gets the pull. He will pull out the back of this one, gets Crescendo. Still get there. And really great work from Clearlove to completely defend against that one. Messiah was kept pretty much paralyzed for a long period of time there, but he just got in front of it and managed to stop the damage coming out from Yellow Pete. Wicked, meanwhile, trying to burn down this top turret.
They did have to burn the Shen ult, but Clearlove's Nocturne ultimate is still available. Snoopy has his flash back. Oracle has got Wicked, got the tower. Good push. Now Xiaomei and Nocturne looking up, and they have a deep ward. They saw him coming in.
So, aggressive stuff now coming out. Is it going to be a Bloodthirster straight away on Jace here? He has got that BF sword to go with those boots he picked up earlier. Meanwhile, Skarner's just going to build as tanky as possible. Skarner's going to be that frontline damage that goes in. And effectively, they're going to play it like a double AD strat. And you can see that is why Wicked's now starting to actually put pressure on Xiaomei there with just the basic attacks.
Those are the Berserker's Greaves coming into happiness right there. He has the red buff as well, which is just allowing him to train him down more and more. Getting him pushed back a bit, despite Wicked having two deaths, he's taken the tower. He has 125 minions to Shen's 111. He is holding his own up there. Both the mid lane and the top lane are actually very, very even. Even the four kills that WE has taken are counteracted by that tower and Dragon Gold, so a good stall so far by COG EU.
Good stall so far, and that's what they want to do. Messiah, not. I mean, he's causing problems for Froggen, but he's not slowing the farm in there. Both keeping even though Snoopy again going to get caught out. Flash will be available in the exact same situation. Snoopy has to flash away. The Ezreal ultimate was going up there, the river. Does manage to catch across them, but again, flash burn for Snoopy. It means he's not going to be able to be too aggressive until line is back available.
Really, the exact same moment as you said. Now goes back, gets that ward. Nocturne ult still on a long cooldown. Once again, they really want to get that Oracles down, and Snoopy's done a good job staying alive and playing safe when his flash was down.
Dragon,
they're clearing the ward here at Dragon. They have the timer on it. It's immediately up. but WE knows they do not have Nocturne or Shen Ultimates here. Even the Ezreal Ultimate is down. CLG has all of theirs as well. So if there is a fight here, this would be one for CLG EU to take.
Yeah, they want to force it. Wicked is there, of course. There's the acceleration gate. Can they try and catch someone out? Or can they just turn this into a straight flat push on the turret, which CLG seem to be doing? It's going to force Team WE to come up river, straight past that ward coverage. So that's going to be a wave pushed into the turret.
W's trying the dragon.
CLG going to come around, though. There is the drag. That's the dragons are already down to half health, and they forced it to reset. CLG aggression coming in. Snoopy's going to clear out that ward he sat on top of. And remember, there is no flash for Snoopy, but that acceleration gate will give him that extra speed to be able to get in and hook someone.
WE is trying to hold this one off right now. They're waiting for their ultimate cooldowns to come back. Ezreal's is back. Chaumaze is almost close. They are pressuring mid, but right now WE is just trying to buy another 20 or so seconds. They're going bottom lane for tower push. They're going to get that. They're going to concede. Then this is going to be a tower trade.
It is going to be a tower trade. The question is, will they continue trading? It's not really the tower trade that CLG were looking for. They were quite happy to take that mid one, but didn't really want to lose that bottom one. Weijiao was there. And again, CLG getting in position. They're going to pick up the blue before they go dragon this time around. They've got to be careful. So Froggen's going to come around. He's going to get the blue before this fight begins. Again, ward clearance begins. Very, very much cat and mouse this one. There's Weijiao with the ultimate going across, and Weijiao's going to back away. He's got to be careful. There's a ward right there. Hasn't going to spotted him in the bush. They won't know he's gone back. They're going to show him. And Shen going up to the top as well. CLG going to be giving this dragon.
But WE is going to take that top tower. Chaume has went all the way up. They pushed the bottom lane with the Ezreal ulti because they're just trying to deny CLG as many minions and as gold as possible while still giving them the dragon. Another dragon for CLG EU. This is really the stall that they actually need. So WE's decision to just kind of split push and trade really just extends the game here. And that's good work by CLG EU getting the second dragon for them.
That's going to be the second turret for WE. Actually, Jace now up that top lane. If you can look at the top lane, please. You can see that Wicked is going to come in there. Not quick enough though. Chaumaze will take the turret down. And blue buff being given to Weijiao.
That is an interesting choice actually, but I say interesting too much, I think, D-Man. But we have Shen.
Oh,
Vladimir
flash.
Is a solo lane, so there he comes in, right for Wicked.
And we just saw Froggen flash out there. Wicked's had to use his flash as well. Froggen flashing away from the potential dazzle. He was so cautious, that means his flash is going to be down. Not too big a deal on Karth, especially now we're moving into a more of a mid-game phase. 20 minutes gone into this match. Still just 600 gold between the two teams. Very much aggressive stuff here from Team WE. They're going to try and push this top lane. There's the Ezreal Ultimate clearing out the bot lane, which you can see Corki is on yellow feet trying to push that bottom turret. There goes the Ultimate actually catching the entire creep wave, stopping him out. Messiah going to come around. The Ghost coming out. They're going to dive in. Crescendo, though, back towards the tower. The Corki, the Karth Ultimate is not going to be enough. Oracle's going to get burned there. Snoopy goes down. Crepo goes down. Team WE cleaning house here for CLG, and Wicked just trying desperately to defend it. Oh my word, FCZF nearly got caught out by the backside of Wicked there, and they're going to come around. Froggen is there. The Wall of Bane should come around. He's going to be careful. He doesn't get caught out too heavily, though. He's going to surely get dropped eventually. There's the Shen ultimate onto Clearlove. He will get taken down. He's going to try and put a couple of laywaves down. He can't catch hold of Messiah. Yellow Pete, in the meantime, is just getting a free farm in the bottom, but that was three kills given to Team WE.
It really isn't that much of a disaster though, because look at the gold toll after this. It's still only a 1,000 gold lead. They didn't get the tower despite getting those 3 to 4 kills on the dive, and CLG EU did. Also, Yellow Pete is going to be able to steal this red buff away, so when all is said and done, that absolute aggression by WE didn't actually gain them all that much. To get back very early, Weijiao getting the blue buff there. Oh no, he might have missed the red buff here. He's got it, but now he's in trouble.
But the dazzle came out already. FCZF used the dazzle to try and get the kill. And Yellow Pete is safe. 7-1 in kills. 3-2 though in turrets to CLG. 22 minutes gone into this game. Very much a lively one. And I think there's a lot of time to be going in this game yet. Crepo, the poke comes out. And that crescendo, we saw how big a part it can play in attack and defense. And they're going to have to use it again here. It's not available just yet. And they're going to lose out in this mid turret. It's going to be 3-3 in turrets. Team WE confident they can go for that one. Messiah in the meanwhile stealing away the raids. And Team WE continue on. There is no blue buff to steal, which is where they're heading now. And how are CLG going to react to them?
They're going to continue to try to stall. They're keeping the turrets very even. And this is something that World Elite has to close out. It's, the onus is on them to finish this one. Nocturne and Shen will not be as strong if this game just... Well, Shen will, but Nocturne is going to have trouble assassinating as it gets later and later. Froggen's Karthus powers up really high. The crescendo dance duration gets more and more impactful as the fights finish. COGEU putting their stall game on. They're down 7-1, but they're right in control of what they're doing right now.
They're right in control. The gold difference is only 1,700 gold. Not that great when you're considering it's at 30,000 plus. So how do you see the item builds going? We can see Bloodthirster already on Jace. Meanwhile, Shen has obviously got that Sunfire Cape already built up there. Looks like a Wit's End probably going to come out next from Chow Mei. How do you spread it across the board? And obviously looking at Vlad compared to Zakarthus as well.
So looking at Messiah right now, when he gets that Death Cap, the Magic Pen is going to crush down. Normally, the Magic Pen build from Vladimir is more successful against teams that don't go. Oh, big fight down by Weezhou.
Big fight, bottom lane. Weezhou diving on towards Yellow Pete. He's got now to it. And Yellow Pete realizes the goose is cooked. Weezhou's going to take him down. And a 1v1 fight. Weezhou very strong and picking up the red buff off Yellow Pete.
Just standing in that bush. Got the ultimate to start the fight. Catching Yellow Pete completely by surprise. And with that Trinity Force, he just got the Phage procs and trained through. This is the pressure WE needs to apply here. They have Shen split pushing in the top lane. His ultimate's back in a couple seconds. The other four are pushing down the bottom turret. CLGEU has to really try hard to stall here. Wicked's going to try to stop Shen from coming in, but the other four are probably going to get this turret uncontested.
Yeah, that turret definitely going down. FZZF going around the backside. Wants to try and maybe open things up with a Dazzle. The ping came down. They were aware of his situation. They back off, but the blue has spawned just at the right moment. And of course, they're going to go in there. Wicked versus Chow Mei, though. Wicked had to knock Chow Mei away there. I think Chow Mei's going to come out
really
on top
careful.
Of this one. He's going to be very careful with this one. He's going to use the acceleration gate. He will be able to get away. The Dawn could come out, could get a full length taunt here from Chow Mei. He's just about in range if he balances it. No, he's going to bait him instead. He's going to try and get towards the taunt. He's going to go down, and that's a straight 1v1 exchange. Chow Mei looking strong. You talked about it earlier, how much stronger he's going to be, and he really is dominating.
And this is trouble for CLGEU because two members now just lost in straight-up 1v1 against their adversaries. Yellow Pete got soloed by Weezhou. Chow Mei soloed Wicked. So in a team fight, if those guys are stronger than you, what's actually stronger for CLGEU? The Froggen, Defile, if he dies in the right spot, and the Crescendo would be better than the Karthus or potentially some of the Vlad damage, but it's going to be really, really tricky. Losing those fights is making it harder and harder for them to turtle because the stronger they make WE, the harder it is to turtle those turrets, and dying 1v1 just cannot happen in this engagement.
And currently, Snoopy only been able to get in and hook one person so far, so not being able to really express himself in the jungle. Dragon, now up. 25 minutes gone, of course, we could be looking at Baron. Reach out, just farming away. And look at the difference between these two. 262 CS compared to 200. Again, massively out farming Yellow Pete. And just, what, 2,000 gold difference. Again, just like game one. These are the differences we saw before. And TWE were very strong in that game.
And Weezhou, along with the very new support FZZF, have done such a great job keeping him in these games. A farmed Ezreal is one of the scariest possible AD carries you can get, and this is really odd to me. He has an Aegis of the Legion on Ezreal, so he's actually going for Bruzy dueling. This might have been how he was able to take out Yellow Pete. They have a double Aegis, but that's in case of a Skarnapul, in case of a Crescendo, in case Jace jumps down on him. He's not going to die. He has enough resistances. This is the first time in competitive setting I've seen that item built on an AD carry.
So we're looking like Baron is going to be started off by Team WE. No vision at the moment from CLG. You just saw it on your screen. They have no idea this is happening. You can see CLG starting to close around. They're going to put the ward down and go, God, we're going to have to react to this one very quickly. Immediately they do react. Team WE going to peel off to the side of this one. And CLG do force them back. That Baron was taken very low, though. Below half health. I think you can see it's just nearly 5,000 hit points left on it. So COG just about reacting in time. They're going to come around in towards the bottom lane. Can they force something off this one? They know that Ezreal is up the top. He's going to be teleporting back right now. So COG going to try and drive home a 5-4 advantage.
And I'm just looking at this Ezreal. He has Ninja Tabi as well. So he's all about dueling. He's just countering up against the physical damage. He's almost a bruiser now with blinks and an AoE ultimate, which is really crazy. I want to watch how these team fights break out as CLGEU is now trying to push in. Taric initiates, really WE's initiates all have to be flash taunt from Chen or something. They don't have something nearly as strong as the Crescendo or the Skarnapul. So CLGEU not in a terrible position here trying to shut down. As the game gets later, they might be able to pull it out.
Well, they're trying to poke comp, what we saw earlier on. And obviously it was from Team WE in the first game as well. They went very much with the poke back and forward, back and forward. You can see it just driving down the hit points. Clear loves there. FZZF, they may be able to get the turret off the back of this one. They've already forced Vlad back. Messiah's coming back now to lane. The turret already taken half the hit points. Wei Zhao now on the side there. They've got to be very careful. They don't get caught out from that one. The ultimate already used, though, by Wei Zhao. Will be available very soon. That True Shot Barrage is very much on a quick cooldown. And there we go. CLG EU again, just driving home and trying to chip away at this turret. And it seems to be working for them. The question is, have they left it a little bit too late? There's the conga line of minions coming in. Messiah, looks like Team WE want to go for this, and they want to try and pull something off the back of this one. And Yellow Pete very cautious in getting a couple of attacks on towards that turret.
And they've done a really good job, actually. Every member of their team has went back and shopped individually while the others held that turret. The fact they hadn't lost it yet is a testament to how well they're turtling here. They're just trying to get powered up before the next team fight. They're making sure their lanes are split pushing. They may just lose the tower here because Nocturne show top, or will CLG EU be too scared of the Nocturne ult? Because an initiation could very well come out of WE here.
He's off the side. He was waiting for Nocturne, waiting for Clearlove to come back there. I'm very much aware of the fact that he could be coming at the side and start initiating something there. So they all backed away from that one. Despite the fact the wave was there. The tower down to next to nothing here. Snoopy coming around. The Wraith being picked up. Ward's being used all over the map. Very much a poke game. And they're just waiting for one team to make that small mistake.
It's still only a 4,000 gold advantage despite the 8 kill advantage. And here comes the team fight.
They're going straight in. There's the Vladimir ultimate. They managed to catch it across two members. Yellow Pete still low. Managed to avoid the damage. Frogman very low. And I think CLG should be able to avoid the damage off the back of this one. You can see Krepo is going to keep the speed up. There's the acceleration gate. They're going to try and push them right back in towards the turret. Are they going to follow it through? Wicked's going to just try and beat them back. And I think, just like we saw Team WE, they're going to get taken one by one. Wicked's got to be very careful. You saw Clearlove. And FZZF just up to the side there, trying to pick through. That's where we saw some crazy Blizzard hooks earlier on.
So now they're trying to poke back down. Even in the previous game, when teamfights were even, WE would always try to push off the back of them. Now CLGU all having to go to shop. WE has a giant wave pushing in the bottom. They need to clear that out, otherwise they're going to take a tower. Someone's going to have to go back and finish that. That's going to give CLG some breathing room to try to get back here. And the stalling is working out very well. They're scouting the Baron buff here. This is really just CLG's classic stall.
Yeah, Wicked getting an attack on the Baron, causing FZZF to take the damage. That bottom lane wave has been dealt with. And Wei Zhao, we saw stealing away the blue buff as well on your screens. 30 minutes gone in this game, and it is a 5,000 gold difference. Team WE already 1-0 up, looking like they are strong favorites to make it into the semifinals versus Azubu Frost. But do not rule CLG EU out. Rule them out at your peril. Moscow 5 did it once, and they were on the back end of a hiding. And honestly, as it is, Team WE, they have the power, but they are just getting poked and driven back by CLG EU constantly here. They've got to be careful they don't get caught out, like something like Wei Zhao right now, just taunting, flirting with Snoopy, saying, come on, hook me.
And now they're poking down the mid lane again. We saw in the last fight, WE tried the full-on engage, and CLG could completely disengage. So right now, that's a good spot for CLG to be in. The fact that if they don't want to fight, they've proven they don't have to. They have enough disengagement, and WE doesn't have strong enough stick. So really, they get to pick their fights, even though they're behind a bit. The main force here for WE in that situation would have to be a Baron. You need to make CLG come to them. It's just with their lead being so minor here, only about 5,000 gold, is that enough? Is it worthwhile to put yourself in the back of Baron? And they're taking that mid tower, closing it even closer.
Well, Team WE were nowhere near reacting to that one. So we're all squaring towers, 4-4. And that's Wei Zhao picking up the second blue buff. So he's taking them all. That's good. Somewhat greedy, some might feel, but he's definitely going to have that one. The split push, of course, down the bottom, you can see Chao Mei. The dragon will be available any second, but Chao Mei just driving it home, continuing to push on. There comes Wicked to try and head him off. Just stop things. Which may mean they'll force something elsewhere. And wow, look at Wicked. You get the exchange coming out there. There is a huge creep wave, though, that Wicked would be able to farm off the back of. Frogman having to use that Wall of Pain to keep them at bay from Yellow Pete. And it's looking like a two-man Baron.
They're trying to do it here. They have FZZF, and Wei Zhao doesn't have a whole bunch of damage because of his very defensive build. But CLG EU is trying to scout. It looks like Snoopy's going to pop over with the ward, and this might not work out for them.
But he has put the ward down. Are they going to risk it? No. Definitely a wise choice to back away from that one. But meanwhile, Wicked and Wei Zhao, and Chao Mei, sorry, very much an even exchange now. You see the damage that he managed to put down on him. But again, Shen, He needs to keep him occupied. This is what you talked about. He needs to keep him busy, keep him fighting. That way he can't use his ultimate to come across. He can't get in there, and that's what prevented them. Instead, he's going to pick up the dragon as a booby prize.
They have the pressure here, and that was a pretty good duel, actually, by Wicked. Shen's build has not quite progressed. Wicked's very squishy. The fact that he's not getting beaten by Shen anymore is a good sign for CLG. When he was getting 1v1'd earlier, that would be the end of it, because if you need to send two members for Shen, that pretty much just ends the game for you. Wei Zhao needs to get that last Whisper finished. He's went with an immensely defensive build thus far, and that might be hurting them slightly in these fights. Since CLG is all about disengaging and isn't actually fighting back, WE needs the all-out damage. If they want to create something to happen, they have to start getting aggressive with their item choices and with their play, because the longer this goes, I think the more comfortable CLG EU becomes.
We're seeing a potential trouble coming out. Vlad could definitely go for a rabbit. He's got the rabbit on Zethcap. He's going to go for the Azonia's Hourglass as well. You can see that other Nidus Nard in there. 282 CS to 297, so 300 CS already for Frog, and we are a long way into it compared to the last game, though. They're collapsing in for that top turret. They do not want to allow another turret to go down. And actually, that's a bit more farm for Wicked there, 9,000. But you can see it's a 1,000 gold difference to Shen. Looking at Froggen versus, well, Froggen's actually very much even in terms of gold, but still, that huge gold difference is very much Wei Zhao versus Yellow B.
And that, all that gold difference, oh, as we see an initiation attempted on Messiah, he's going to disengage. That gold difference is all in the Aegis of the Legion, so damage perspective-wise, if they can keep Yellow Pete safe, he's got actually a little bit more damage than Wei Zhao right now. It's just, Wei Zhao's much, much harder to kill.
Well, they know that Wei Zhao is off the difference there. Are they going to try and choose that advantage? He did show himself. The ping's going down from... I think Team WE wanted to continue pushing that. I think they wanted Wei Zhao just to stay there. Instead, Chen's going to go across. They can keep that split push. Of course, if CLG were to try and force something at the Baron, he could easily just ultimate across and join the fight. As it is, Taric got to be very careful. He wants to get in and put some wards down. CLG kind of in that back and forth position. They're not quite sure where they should go right now.
And WE, in my opinion, is also not quite sure where they want to go right now, because they have not been able to force fights on CLG, and this is honestly starting to get a little reminiscent of the M5 versus CLG EU game at DreamHack, just because they've only had one kill the entire game, but they're still in it and they're still stalling. And it's just a matter of WE has tried a few things to create action and just hasn't really worked, and they haven't committed fully to any of these things. They're waiting so long that by the time they actually fully commit, it could be the end of the game for them if they lose the fight. If I was them, I would try to get a little bit more aggressive right now, because if something fails now, you might have time to come back from it, since the death timers aren't 70 seconds long yet. However, they keep waiting. They're hoping CLG EU makes a mistake, but CLG EU is one of the best stalling teams in the land. It's going to be very difficult for them.
So a Deathfire Grasp has just been picked up by Froggen on Karthus.
Deathfire Grasp is one of his favorite items, and this is just, if they try to initiate in on them, if Nocturne jumps on him, DFG's hitting him right away, and with how much ability power that is, it's going to be 40% of Nocturne's health almost straight away. That's a great item for Froggen's Karthus. He's going to be getting more magic penetration later, but that is not surprising. Really good build so far by Karthus, just powering up.
Wei Zhao on that top lane. He's got to be careful he doesn't get caught out. You can see that Snoopy heading up that way. Just going to clear the wave out. CLG doing a great job, but just like you say, just continuing just to hold, stall, farm out. And honestly, now we are looking at a massive late game. It's definitely getting to that stage again. Baron gets targeted there, and MZZF gets attacked. Ezreal, True Shot Barrage there, going across the other beat, not doing a great deal of damage off that one. Obviously, the big difference is he did go for that tanky
build. Oh, Nocturne up top!
Nocturne up top, they're going to dive in towards Wicked. Wicked manages to knock him away. He has got the Ignite on, but that's going to be the turret damage going down there. He's got no support just yet. They're also triggering on Baron. Baron is going down as well, so Wicked is trying to keep them away from this inhibitor turret. Now we can look over Baron, please. You can see that CLG is starting to go in there. There's the Crescendo
going
across. That's going to be the Vladimir Ultimate. Meanwhile, Wicked and Karthus is trying to force them away. That's going to be Froggen picking up the kill on Chaumei. The Ultimate's coming across. Is it going to help Snoopy out? He's going to get the double kill off the back of it! He's taken down Nocturne. MZZF has managed to survive, though, and Yellow Pete backs away from that one. Very much a close exchange, but it was a 1-for-2, and CLG coming out on top for the first time in that one. Very crazy fight.
You could see what WE's plan was there, was to distract everyone up top and then sneak the Baron, but CLG had the perfect counter for it. They stopped the Shen teleport as well as the Shen push bottom. That was an amazingly quick reaction by CLG, and they held off that ploy by WE.
WWE now going to be really struggling to find what to do next, because that's the second time they've tried to force something very hard and neither of them have been successful. That one actually backfired a little bit.
And the tanking is starting to get going, building towards the frozen mallet there for Wicked. So Wicked now with the damage and the tank. We're going to have a replay coming up with this one. Take us through it, Jack.
And here's the huge thing. Wicked waiting and waiting for Froggen to come in. The Baron's going on. They try to teleport in, but he knocks him back. And because he was looking at the other fight when he teleported in, because he was trying to get there, Wicked did a great job holding his knockback. The double kill then came out from Karthus. So Shen tried to be a global presence. Froggen was a global presence. And that's why COG came out in that fight.
Couple of items being completed. Zhonya's Hourglass with Messiah, we knew that one was being built. Force of Nature by Chao Mei though. Infinity Edge also being picked up by Yellow Pete. And again, the Baron Pope comes out there and they just force it away. Kripo doing a grand job of keeping him at bay.
Seems like WWE does not want to try a full-on engagement at Baron. That's why they keep trying to sneak it with a couple people. They don't want to fight.
Kripo continuing to just aggress. Every time FZZF, he goes in to try and take that Baron, he's just poking. Here he comes again. He's just going to queue on towards the Baron. I don't think he's going to be able to do it this time. Very cautious. He didn't get caught out by Wei Zhao. And the poke back and forward continues. So, late game. We're getting there. We are there. Who would you give it to in terms of a team fight right now?
The fact that COG has stalled this long and they have the Karthus Sona, very good synergy. I do think COG might actually have pulled ahead here just based on how long they've waited. And it shows in the play that WWE has been trying to pull off. They're trying to split COG up. They've had an opportunity, if they've wanted it, to put five men on Baron and then peel when COG comes to stop them. But they haven't done that in the past 20 minutes, so there's no real reason for them to do it now. Really, it's so much patience by CLG and just know-how that WWE can't force anything strong on them here. When Nocturne jumps in on these fights, he's going to get obliterated almost immediately. The DFG is going to come down and hit him. Corki now has more damage than Wei Zhao because he has not went for a defensive build. And if they can't directly jump on Yellow Pete, that tank build of Wei Zhao isn't going to come into any use.
Dragon being picked up by Team WWE, and it's a 7k gold difference currently. Towers dead even. 4v4. Oh, they're going to try and catch on there. Throwing pressure down. Wall of Pain's on Messiah. Messiah getting shredded. The Vlad, I don't think he's going to catch away. Froggen gets the kill though. Can they turn this into something? Yellow Pete having to Valkyrie away there. Just about getting caught out. But CLG now going to try and push the advantage on. And the crowd definitely turning in favor. They're going to try to pick up the Baron off the back of this one. I'm not too sure it's a great thing to go for though.
They've waited so long. They have not made any moves. This is their move. They got the pick onto Vladimir. They may as well just try this. Shen's trying to split push. They're going to force him to come in. They are going for this. Or they're going to peel. Wicked's behind the side.
They're going to peel. Froggen looks like he wants to catch. He's caught the Wall of Pain. He's going to go for FCZ. FCZ's going to get dropped down. Clear up, meanwhile. There's the Shen ultimate. He comes in. Wei Zhao still off the side. Giving the damage. That's the Hawk from Doobie. Clear up goes down. Double kill again for Froggen. Now they can turn to Baron in safety and surely pick it up.
They're still potentially going to try to stall, but that was an amazing peel. They got the Karthus well down. They have the initiation. WWE clearly does not, because they are not fighting on their own terms here. CLGU trying to get it. Ezra's going to try to come in and steal with his ultimate, but that is not even going to be close. That was for Harass. Here comes CLGU now. The stall has happened 40 minutes into the game. They've gotten 5 of the last 6 kills. They're in control.
Yellow Pete's going aggressive there. He wants to catch out Wei Zhao. I'm not too sure if Wei Zhao is actually sticking around, you know. He wants to still get aggressive on this one. Look at the damage he's still trying to put out to them. Not too sure that's the wisest thing in a 2-on-1 situation, but they do manage to harass. They've taken the inhibitor turret there. Very nicely done by Chao Mei. Picking up off the back of that one. There's a flash comes out. That's a cleanse. I think that was a Quicksilver Sash actually from Wei Zhao there. But Snoopy might be able to hook onto him. Instead, they spot in the middle, Messiah coming round. Messiah's trying to close in. Yellow Pete, he's had the ultimate down on Messiah. How much damage will that take up? Oh, that chunked him down, but it was not to be. They pulled off at the right moment.
Now the counter-aggression is potentially on. It seems like WE is a bit lost, though. Their disorganization in these last few bits have cost them. They're now trying to regroup. They need to keep their composure. That delay may have put them a bit on tilt. They haven't been able to finish this here. They get another turret, so the gold advantage is still in their favor, but CLG has the Baron buff. They are still up inhibitors. Having that inhibitor open does give WE some access to the base, but they lose team fights at this point. This has been shown, so CLG actually in control despite the positioning on the map.
Yeah, and we often say that Baron is worth around about 8,000 gold, which actually in terms of this at the moment, if they were to force a fight, would definitely give the advantage. But Team WE really driving home a bit of a lapse of daisy coolness from CLG. So, you know, the big advantage they picked up off the back of that Team WE have responded and picked up three turrets after the Baron was taken.
It really seems like CLG was low on health and mana and wanted to buy, and WE had all respawned right after the Baron took off. Now they're pushing up mid, WE trying to get back. And this is such a great position for CLG to be in because WE can't necessarily engage the Crescendo. Such a good stop. They have the acceleration gate from Jace. They have the slowing wall from Froggen. Complete control. They will fight on CLG's terms. If they want to poke the tower, they will. If WE wants to fight, they can't.
They need to try and get in there early. Now Team WE, though, have responded. And the poke again from CLG should be strong. We saw it earlier on when they took that middle and inner turret. And you can see the poke going back. FZZ taken completely down there. Weezhou, though, the tankiness showing through there. You can see he's just going to lifesteal it back. All that damage that goes out. We saw how strong Messiah's ultimate was when he caught onto towards Yellow Pete. Yellow Pete's got to be very, very careful. He doesn't get caught out by that this time. Has got no magic resist at all. So anything from Messiah would definitely be very painful for Yellow Pete.
The thing with Froggen here is all of CLG kills are concentrated on him. He is close to maxed out on items. If there's a big fight here, he's going to be the one dying, and they would actually have to be fairly careful. The steal coming through by Weezhou. Very nice ultimate.
Very, very nice stuff from Weezhou. We've seen a few of those this tournament as well. Definitely a move that a lot of players have been making use of. Oh, CLG going to continue pushing here. Team WE a little bit out of position. Are they going to collapse around them? I'm not too sure. Team WE has been known to collapse on opponents before and make it work. And instead, we're seeing Wicked using the acceleration, poking out. And I think Team WE are going to be able to respond and close back in. There is a creep wave on the bottom pushing in for CLG. So they're going to have that available to switch to in a few moments. If they don't quite get the poke on this turret that they want, Yellow Pete, you can see, just putting a couple of those rockets out, trying to keep poking, but Weezhou is too tanky and the lifesteal's coming out too strong. Wall of Pain, not going to be able to do a great deal. They are going to drop the creep waves, but honestly, Team WE are reacting very quickly. Expect them to rotate down to that bottom lane for that big creep wave.
And WE really needs to trick CLG into fighting in a bad spot because they've been in this situation for so long. Have not been able to initiate anything. CLG's experience really coming in huge here. Most teams, when you're down 1-0 in a tournament and then 9-1 in the next game, you would give up. Oh, but CLG EU was in complete control, and now they're poking down this turret really hard.
They realized that Weezhou had backed off, and suddenly they took that advantage and shredded the turrets. Bottom turret now gone down. Minions did it themselves on that bottom lane. It's 7-5 in turrets, and that gold gap gets ever shorter. Just 5,000 gold now. We were about 8,000 at one point. And again, this is what we talked about. Do not rule CLG out. Once they get to that late stalled out game, they generally know what they're doing. This is in their territory right now, and Team WE are up against it.
And this is the team play. The most experienced teams seem to be better in team fights and the late game. We saw it earlier. WE has two new members, so a lot of times you can get your early game coordination because so much of that is laning and individual skill, and you can prep for the first 20 minutes of the game. But once it breaks down, once all the towers are there, once everyone's roaming around as five, it really matters how much experience you have together. And CLG EU, with the trip to Korea, with the gaming house, knowing each other since the game launched, playing together in Europe, they are showing how coordinated they can be because they have come back from a very big disadvantage, stalled extremely well, kept their cool, and they team fight like champions.
I think it's safe to say we're in the longest game of the tournament so far. 45 minutes gone in this one, 10-6 in kills, and the creep score of the opponents is definitely getting very high. 433 CS for Weezhou. Meanwhile, Yellow Pete on 335. That goal difference is 3k difference, but that's not such a big deal right now because those end builds are starting to come out. So while we're talking about it's a 3k goal difference, which in itself is big, if you look at the items, you can see he's got the Trinity Force, the Infinity Edge, the Guardian Angel, which is a big key thing and something we saw in Wasco 5 obviously generally relying on. However, you look at Weezhou, if he can be allowed to do all the damage, he's got a hell of a lot of it. Bloodthirst, the Trinity Force, Last Whisper, Quicksilver Sash to escape, Aegis of Legion to defend. He is very, very strong come a team fight.
And it's just a matter of the team fights aren't coming for him because CLG is unengageable in a lot of ways. This was potentially won at Champion Select if CLG EU can take it down. Shen trying to sneak a split push on the inhibitor. He's definitely going to try. This is their gambit because they know they can't get team fights. If they can somehow sandwich CLG between them, then maybe they can create something. He's actually having to fall back because at this point, Wicked may have built enough damage that Shen can no longer duel him.
Yeah, he definitely meant to back off, go for the lane. Well, the Baron buff will be wearing off shortly, but CLG have made use of it. They've taken one of the turrets, the inhibitor turret, down to absolutely nothing. Meanwhile, obviously, CLG's inhibitor turret on the bottom lane is gone. It is very, very close between these two. Baron's up in 30 seconds, which is why we're seeing CLG backing off. They are going to farm up, make sure they're fully prepared for this next Baron fight. And you can see Team WE have already backed off as well, so they're getting prepared for it. So the next fight is definitely going to be a game changer.
This is going to be the turning point, really, for both teams, because previous Barons have been World Elite, poking around and having the advantage while trying to split push. But this time, it's now CLG EU who has the upper hand. You don't see it in the gold, you don't see it in the kills, but you see it in the way the teams are playing, because all of the pressure and control is in the hands of Froggen's team. So here, they're poking down. The Shen split push is now forcing something. It's going to be a matter of CLG having to force something or send him back, because otherwise they're going to lose this backdoor inhibitor.
He's on the inhibitor. Shen is going to be dead working on it. We can see CLG going to push their own inhibitor. Shen's going to have to react. He's going to try and steal that inhibitor and then ultimate back. Here we go. There they go. The turning point comes in. CLG were well aware of that one. They managed to knock the little back. Snoopy's in there, trying to look at all the action going on. Yellow Pete's going to get taken down very low. Messiah's going to get in there. Pops the ultimate across the entire team. The crescendo comes across. The Dazonia's hourglass from Pop. CLG are dropping though. Flies on the back of this one. Team WE is definitely coming out on top. There's the Karthus ultimate though. Should be able to come back out. Doesn't pick up the kill. Messiah and Wicked in there. But Chao Mei comes back. Guardian Angel comes back. He takes down Crepo. Just the last one. Crepo manages to get the kill. Yellow Pete very low. Chao Mei should be able to get a taunt on him. He's got the health of his support. Ever the support is there, and it's a 3-on-4 exchange. CLG coming out top. More importantly, the AD carry alive, and they're gonna take that inhibitor down.
The first big play there by CLG EU, pushing into the base. The fans chanting CLG behind us. Everyone's gonna be rezzing after this. They can't go for a two-man Baron. The one inhib for the other. Shen, Chao Mei's trying to push back a bit. That inhibitor, still full health. He could not get very started on it.
Did not get started on it, but Chao Mei definitely farming up like a pro. But yeah, he couldn't get involved in it. We're going to see a replay of the last fight. Jat, take us through that craziness.
This was a crazy extended fight. So much of this was WE.
Walk out, we need Vlad.
I'm going for Vlad inside.
I'm running on Vlad.
I'm going for Vlad. Vlad. I have excuse.
We need Ezreal down the fighting.
I can't kill this.
Care for this.
He's down!
Yes! Shen! Tarik!
Shen's there! Shen here!
Give it to him, Pete!
You need to hit him!
Peach!
Nice! Yes! Get the inhib! He can last you!
You can see what it means to these teams. They are very much passionately involved in this game. And that was a pretty crazy fight.
There was so much going on. You could actually see the target calls coming out, potentially a bit confusing. They were calling Taric when he wasn't even close to the battle. They were maybe not fully coordinated there, but they still came out on top. That was the first time WE actually initiated. They got the Shen taunt onto multiples, and that was the only brawl we've really seen in this entire 50-minute game. But because they came out on top of that, they managed to drop Tank Reach out. He's now abandoned the tank build, went for full Infinity Glass Cannon, now much more damage. CLG trying to clear wards around the Baron area. They're scouting with that Ezreal ult, trying to help with the blue buff. And ooh, Messiah had to take that away. This is going to be really, really game deciding the next big fight, because the death timers are huge. And if we don't see another crazy trade of four members alive on both sides, something will end.
A good chunk of damage going in towards Clear Level and Chao Mei's face there as they walk straight headlong into that bush. The acceleration gate, bunch of shots there. Look at that. Wei Zhao's been lost a bit of health. He's going to be able to lifesteal that back, but CLG definitely poking down at Team WE. They have no vision of that Baron at all. No vision what CLG are doing. So every time, every attempt they try and make to try and squeeze those wards in there, there's only one ward available now to Team WE. They're almost out of wards. They're going to have to go blind into this fight. FZZ, you can see, he really wants to get that ward in, but he's so careful he doesn't get hooked out. That wall of pain, the acceleration gate, if every time they go close, they're getting a burst of damage in their face.
This is just CLG controlling here. They might catch out Clear Love here. They're going for it.
They're going for Clear Love. Has he got him? Yes, he does. Clear Love's going to get dropped down here. He's going to try and use his ultimate. Go and get away. It is not going to happen. Froggen picks up the kill off the back of this one. CLG now in a four-man advantage. Going to turn it back to Baron. They're not going to drive it home, which is a wise choice. There's a huge creep wave on the bottom inhibitor turret right now for CLG. If you just look down there, look at that. That's going to work the damage. They're going to have to deal with it. Team WE have backed off this one. It's going to be a Baron for CLG.
A free Baron here. 52 minutes into the game. They're pulling ever closer to
to that gold, but the gold does not matter for COG right now. People are at max item build. They have the better late game team comp, and more importantly, they stick together. They have not been getting picked off. WE has been getting picked off. They're pushing down these turrets now. What is going to be able to stop them? Because they have been so patient. They have played together so incredibly well, and now they might be able to finish this one off.
We talk about that huge death timer. Still 12-20 seconds on Clearlove. Clearlove's not going to be involved in this fight. Now you can see Wicked just drilling home. The difference of having Jace and Yellow Pete in there, they can just have a double AD attack. They are stacking out, and those inhibitors are just getting dropped like flies. Wei Zhao's going to be careful he doesn't get pulled up. They're just going to back away from this one, say job done. When two inhibitors are down, it is very, very hard to come back from. And COG EU realize they have a very strong position. Clearlove now back up, and COG are going to just go, thank you very much, we'll go bye.
At least for Froggen now, his item build is completely finished. He's going to go back to base and power up on elixirs. Now that they have two inhibitors finished, it's time to turn on the game-ending machine. They're going to take probably the bottom inhibitor next. When there's two waves of super minions pushing into a team's base, the third inhibitor is usually likely to follow as long as the team just groups up in that spot. Yellow Pete picks up a red buff. Chow Mei trying to hold off. These guys are nearly at max item, so that gold doesn't matter. The kills don't matter. What does matter is the team comp, the players, and how they finish.
So as you hear, the inhibitor is going to be respawning in that mid lane. A couple of items. Guardian Angels, of course, starting to get picked up across the board. Definitely the late game items of choice. 500 plus CS for Wei Zhao. Chow Mei starting to farm up like a pro as well, and wow, such huge numbers, as you'd expect in a 54-minute game. COG on the attack. Clearlove, again, has to be careful. He doesn't get caught out. That's going to be the speed buff used. Clearlove is going to get caught. He's going to have the shield. He's got a Guardian Angel. It is not going to matter. It's going to get popped back up in a moment, but he is going down from this one. There's no way. Even with a flash, the Shen Ultimate is going to get dropped down. Shen Ultimate now wastes. That's going to be an explosive point straight across. Josiah gets dropped. Wei Zhao, look at the damage. He is just getting choked down. COG are going to take this game. We are going to see a third match in this best of three series. Chow Mei going to respawn off the Guardian Angels. He's going to get dropped off the back of that one. They don't give a hell about him. Now, I had to adopt my words there, but he's going to get taken down. The Nexus turrets are being attacked. They're going to tank it up. CLG EU are taking it to game three.
And finally, at the end of it, they do come ahead on kills and on goals. So this is incredible.
The crowd are on their feet. The team are on their front. And CLG, you see what it means to them. The crowd are chanting their name, and that's got to feel good. After such a long delay, Jack, the mindset of both these sets of players is really going to be affected. After a 55-minute match there, 13-14 at the end. In fact, the gold advantage became CLG's just at the end of it. And Team WE, they've got to be careful they're not too deflated on the back of that.
You can see Froggen shouting in-game and outside of it. They are so charged right now. And when we saw this, this is honestly, even though it wasn't 70 minutes, very reminiscent of COG's play at DreamHack against Moscow 5. Being down 8 or 9 kills and then just coming out on top. After they did that to Moscow 5, they'd won the tournament. Like, you saw Moscow 5 was dejected. They were up so far and they couldn't finish. World League can't make the same mistake. They have to get back into the game here, because winning a game in that fashion can be demoralizing to the enemy. They seemingly had everything in control. CLG, you knew a lot better. They took him out.
They knew a lot better. That poke comp, they dragged it out. They were 9-1 down in kills. Team WE, they realized they had to try and push the advantage. They had that stronger lane comp with the Nocturne, the Shen. They could get involved. But CLG, they are well wise to those tricks. And they did manage to drag it out. So the very first best of three here, the third match game will be coming up. We're going to have a replay, though, of that final push. And we're going to hear how crazy it gets for CLG.
Finish.
Oh. Yeah, baby!
Yes!
Woo! Yes!
Fox!
Yes!
Oh, Yellow Pete, forever the German. Just not emotional at all. Just sat there. It's like, I'm just going to finish the game. You guys celebrate. I'm just attacking the Nexus. I've got to make sure my basic attacks hit perfectly. But, wow. I mean, how do you respond to the reaction to Froggen? I think that's how every CLG fan out there felt.
Every CLG fan was just screaming, yes, yes, every time they came back in those fights. Even from the 9-1, you're just like, they can do it again. I've seen this before. And you could tell they believed it that whole time after the game. They've turned tournaments like this before. And also, Clear Love in these situations, one of the newest members of the team, especially a young team like this for World Elite, how did they react to that? Because CLG EU was together, they are charged, screaming in unison there at the end. They're in good shape coming into Game 3.
And that, I mean, the catch out in the middle wasn't so bad. Yes, it happens. But the one in the bottom, that is low-level play. You know, getting caught out so far in that bottom lane by the opposition when you've got no vision of them.
It's what happens when you play after an hour-long delay or whatever that was in a 60-minute game. The mental fatigue really starts to hit you, and that might have been happening for World Elite. They have to reset here because there's no way Clear Love would make that mistake normally, but I think under the circumstances, under the pressure, under the mental pressure he is under, it's just, it happens, and they can't let it happen in Game 3.
They cannot let it happen in Game 3. Let's just have a look through some of those scores. 8-2-6 for Froggen, very much in control of his situation, but again, the farming was very, very close between these. In the lane phase, it was massive compared to, you know, Wei Zhao, again, out-farming Yellow Pete. That's something they've still got to be concerned of.
And Wei Zhao may have had the highest minion score in the entire tournament thus far.
513.
513.